The National Book Development Board launches its Book Nook project. In just 6 months, the agency was able to set up 52 indigenous and remote reading spaces all over the Philippines. For more on this, we are joined by Charisse Aquino-Tugade, Executive Director of the National Book Development Board. Charisse, good morning and welcome to the program.
Good morning. Thank you for having me today.
With the pandemic, books have become even less accessible for Filipinos all around the country. How is the Book Nook project of the NBDB changing that?
What we're trying to do is to make sure that we have access points to Philippine content. So if you go to many of our bookstores and our libraries, content in our own languages are lacking, and content of our own experience. So we do want to provide that to the different spaces all around the Philippines in areas where it is highly, highly accessible. So with a Book Nook, we have spaces in your palengke, in your pasalubong centers, in tourist and culture hubs, even in weaving centers. So we do want to make this more accessible for the wider public.
And you'll be able to find all types of books there, but what are the best sellers? What are the most in-demand books? Maybe the hard-to-find ones? Does each Book Nook have a fair share of all these genres?
Totally. We have about 1,500 titles of Filipino authored books. So you will have, you will find hard to find books such as Filipino graphic novels. And we do know that kids love to look at these, you know, Pinoy comics, but it's so difficult to get them everywhere. So each of these Book Nooks from Ifugao to Tawi-Tawi, here's one in Ifugao right behind me. They will have Filipino graphic novels. We actually have the complete, most of Ambeth Ocampo's work. You'll have a ton of children's books. Halo Halo Especial. You have, books by Rio Alma and books by all of these like really wonderful writers and illustrators. We really wanted to make it as comprehensive as possible. So we do have books from preschool to 12th grade, and we do have some adult books as well.
And Charisse, books in Filipino are quite few compared to the international ones, with a 24-to-1 import-export disparity. Can you share with us what this means for book readers?
It's such a kind of a difficult number to swallow, this 24-to-1. You know, when we get too many, I guess, imports of our books, then it doesn't encourage people to create their own content. And it's just this crazy, cycle. And we have so many different languages. And, you know, there's, if someone, you know, if let's say you're Iranun or Maguindanaon or Ifugaon, you want your children to read, to just learn how to count in their own language and in their own, I guess, culture, and that's not available, it could be problematic. We were colonized for so long, for 444 years, and it just, that kind of issue, it just compounds. And we do want people to be empowered to realize that our own heritage and our own culture is important, and to start putting that great oral tradition that we have to print. So this is specifically why we chose a lot of indigenous and remote areas where the language is still alive and the epics are still thriving, not only for them to read, but to start writing and creating in their own languages. It's extremely important.
Well, in Davao del Norte, even a bus can be a book nook. How many books are available, and how do you keep the supply up? How do you keep the book nook going?
So the book nook is not really just a site. It's a community. So what we do, there's a fun picture of the bus. What we do is we work as co-developers and co-creators with the community, and we really do so much training, like storytelling training, library science, culture and tourism management, Scrum agile programming, so that when once we set up, it takes about 6 months to set up. So once we set up the community, make sure all of the books are there, that the community is actually equipped to run, right? So now is an important time for everyone to support, because now we're up and running, right, in these 52 sites. And we have programming for everyone, so hopefully people can support, right? That's the only way that this will survive and thrive, is with the support of the community, with reading sessions, storytelling sessions, and Facebook social media is a huge deal, so if everyone can spread the word, then we can sustain this program. By next year, we hope to build about, not build but co-create, about 40 more sites. So hopefully it all works out with everyone's support and collaboration.
That's right. Well, from the photos, we can see that sometimes you do have reading sessions held there. We also saw maybe a schedule of all the other activities. Are there expansion plans or possibilities for these book nooks? What else can they be used for or grown into? You did mention that you wanted to co-create 40 more sites.
Someone asked us if it was a library, and it's not really a library. It's just a really cool hub. It's a little bit of a library, a little bit of like a reading center, a little bit of an art hub, a little bit of like a theater space. So it's this hybrid space that can really be transformed into anything. It's really a storytelling kind of space that everyone can use, and can also not only physically, but we can go out, we can do online, do different programming. There's a lot of offsite now. Even before we started, we had a lot of offsite, just kind of storytelling sessions and all of that good stuff.
Right. So, do you actually do have digital books as well, e-books made available at certain sites? And how many readers have you been able to reach so far?
And with this, we have 52 communities. So you just times that by the population of the barangay and the population of the actual town. So we will reach a good amount of people. And, next year, it's just going to get bigger.
Have there been results out on these book nooks? What is the hope for these readers?
In terms of results, I guess we're just here to do two things. We need to provide access points to our own content, so we help local publishers spread their content out through kind of the rest of the country. And then in tandem, we inspire readers, just the communities, to just read and start writing in their own language and being proud of that, and giving that agency to our own voice.
Right. And finally, the registration is 10 pesos, but borrowing the books are completely free. For how long can you borrow these books?
It depends. It's kind of like a library system. So you have a week, sometimes it's 5 days. And I think because there's still areas that are still, kind of locked down and it's still a little bit iffy, they can borrow for a longer time. And we do encourage everyone. I mean, it's just 10 pesos for the registration, and this will be, they can borrow like for free. Anyone can borrow for free, hopefully like in perpetuity, right? We don't want to charge for this, for sure.
All right, Charisse Aquino-Togade of the National Book Development Board, a pleasure to speak with you today. Thank you so much for sharing your work with us, and hope for your more success.
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.